So here we are again, back by unpopular and relentlessly stubborn demand. And by stubborn, I mean I'm being stubborn, in that I'm going to keep marching to the beat of my own particular drum. And in this case, it brings me to a band that I've wanted to take a look at for a long time. A band that didn't seem to make much of an impact here in the UK. I think they did much better in Germany and Holland and the places where rock music has traditionally maintained a stronger base. They were very big in America. They were massive in South Africa. They remain massive in South Africa. When I tell South Africans that people in the UK have never heard of them, they are astonished. I was lucky enough to see them three times in South Africa. On one of those occasions, it was possibly the worst sound, worst light show, worst video coverage of a live concert, worst venue I've ever seen. And yet the band transcended all of those things in its performance. They are, for me, a band that writes incredible, incredible songs, just incredibly, incredibly catchy earworms. And also sings and performs with its heart on its sleeve. An awful lot of the lyrics that Ed, the singer and writer, writes are quite impenetrable. Secret Samadhi, possibly my favorite album, contains some of the least impenetrable lyrics I think I've ever seen, which makes doing them on this channel quite hard. So I've picked a song that is a very simple piece of lyric writing with a very simple message that's, in fact, off their first album, Mental Jewelry. But I just really, really wanted to ping this band onto the radar of those few of you who follow me on these journeys into the unknown, follow me on these journeys into bands you don't know and songs you don't know, because I think live are worthy of our attention. I think they are a better band than people possibly give them credit for. And obviously, I think this song has something important to say and is being said by people who are important to me. So this is Live, The Beauty of Grey. Oh, fail. This is now Live, The Beauty of Grey.
This is called The Beauty of Grey.
That's what I said.
Told you he was your brother, you'd reminisce and you would go about your day. If I said you ought to get some of your water, you shake your canteen and walk away. And the perception that divides you from him is a lie. For some reason we never ask why. This is not a black and white world. You can't afford to believe side. This is not a black and white world to be alive. I see the colors must swell, and I believe maybe today we will all get to appreciate the beauty of gray.
As simple as that. Simple as that, these lyrics could not be more straightforward. Let's be honest. They're about this incredible thing that we call race. And let's be perfectly honest, race extends beyond the color lines into all sorts of weird, as Neil Peart put it, better the pride that resides in a citizen of the world than the pride that divides when a colourful rag is unfurled. Nationalism. This sense that somehow the place you were born matters, or at least that you should take pride in that place just because you were born there. I'm sure your country's done lots that you can be proud of, but I'm sure it's done an awful lot that you shouldn't be. Mine has. Both of mine have. Both countries I call home have done some hideous things, both in the name of black and white. I take no pride in my country. I take pride in people. I take pride in people that make the world better. If I told you he was your brother, we could reminisce, then you could go about your day. If I said you ought to give him some of your water, you'd shake your canteen and walk away. That's an interesting line, right? Shake the canteen as if to say, well, I've only got so much water, so I can't share it with him, even though you've told me he's my brother. Spiritually, we all come from the same egg. He's not enough of my brother to justify giving up some of my scarcity for him. The perception that divides you from him is a lie. For some reason, you never asked why. This is not a black and white world. You can't afford to believe in your side. I've been living in South Africa since 1982. I was 15 when we got there. I probably didn't really understand, and I spent quite a long time being lied to by the apartheid government. The further we get away from that, and the more I educate myself and the more I see the world, the more this is absolutely my firm belief. You can't afford to believe in your side. You can't afford to believe this perception that divides you from somebody else just on some arbitrary line. You can absolutely make a decision about who to like and who not to like based upon who they are, but not what they are. Certainly not what the colour of their skin is, or their accent, or their language, or whether they eat with a knife and fork or not. This is not a black and white world. To be alive, the colours must swirl. And I believe that maybe today we will all get to appreciate the beauty of grey. We've not got there yet. I think maybe we might head in that direction. But we're all still stubbornly clinging to that black and white world. And honestly, it's shockingly lazy.
Appreciate the beauty of grey. I told you she was your mother. We could analyze the situation and be gone. If I said you ought to give her some of your water, your eyes would light up like the dawn. And the perception that divides you from her is a lie. For some reason, man, we never asked why. This is not a black and white world. You can't afford to believe.
So, it's interesting that he uses water in his imagery. If I said you ought to give her some of your water, your eyes would light up like the dawn. My dad's a water engineer. He spent some years building fairly ordinary and mundane things, but eventually he spent the latter half of his career dealing with environmental water affairs. Quite a smart man, was eventually sent to Vietnam to help them rewrite their water laws on the basis of having been part of South Africa's rewriting of its water laws. And I say that not because it's relevant to this song, but because I'm super proud of my dad. But my dad gave me a book one day called Water Wars, and it detailed stories about how we have fought wars over water, but also how during the fighting of wars, we have not touched the water. Israel and the Middle East, countries that share the same source of water, that will be fighting a bitter, acrimonious, generational war. Don't mess with the water, because water is life. So when Ed uses water as his imagery, he doesn't say, If I said you could give her some of your burger, your money, your wealth, or even your time, he says, some of your water. Because as Frank Herbert was so astute in pointing out, water is ultimately life. And it's lovely. It pinged me particularly that he uses water as his imagery. But before we jam on with this great song, the other reason I wanted to look at live is because in the last Nightwish song I looked at, I deliberately, well, not deliberately, but I kicked over a bit of a hornet's nest by asking the question, are the members of this band particularly fantastic musicians? Are they virtuoso? Are they in their own right brilliant? And that was not meant as a criticism. That was simply, it was me trying to understand the way the world works. And in my conversations with some people subsequently to that, I've pointed out that you don't have to be a virtuoso musician to make great music. This band, I don't believe a single member of this band is a particularly brilliant musician. I don't believe he's a fantastic guitarist. I don't believe he's an especially great bass player. I don't believe the drummer's any great shakes. I think Ed has got a really unique voice, but I don't think that they are a band made up of splendid virtuoso musicians, but they have made splendid music, virtuoso music, songs that are earworms, songs that get your foot stomping. All this to say, music is not, you know, some bands build their virtuosity bake it into the cake of their songs. Some bands, the cake of their song is the virtuosity. This is one of those. They have created some amazing songs. They've created some songs that are emotionally intense, that are evocative, that take me back, that are wrapped up in memories for me, and they are quite brilliant. None of them are particularly brilliant musicians, but as a band, they are absolutely stunning. And I urge you to take a dig into their back catalogue. I mean, these young guys in, was it 92 that they wrote this song? It was Mental Jewelry 92. It might have been. They were young men from Pennsylvania, and they wrote a series of absolutely stunning albums. Albums that contain truth and passion and songs that will worm their way into your mind. Back in white world, to get out, my city colors must swell, and I believe maybe today we will all get to appreciate. Yeah, we will all get to appreciate the beauty of gray. It's not a black and white world to be alive. My city colors must swell, and I believe maybe today we will appreciate the beauty of gray. This is my black and white world to be alive. My city colors must swell, and I believe maybe today we will all get to appreciate. The beauty of gray.
Preach, Eddie. Preach, baby.
There's an intensity to doing videos like this. There's a focusing of the mind. But when Eddie sang "It's a New Day Now," I nearly got me. It's a new day now. This is not a black and white world. To be alive, the colours must swirl. If you allow yourself to understand and see the world in all of its complex beauty, if you go out there and meet people from different cultures that speak different languages and see the world in a different way to you, the net, the sum effect of that will be to make a much, 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 much richer and more colourful world for yourself and for those people. And I say that coming from the new Rainbow Nation, which has its fair share of problems, which is still racked by a black and white thinking, but within which there are beautiful grey people who make my life more beautiful. It's a new day now. This is a great band. I love this band. I'm going to have to find some more of his lyrics that make some sense to me, because they deserve our attention more than I deserve yours. Thank you for watching. I hope you do so again. Until then, keep the faith.